My homemade water filter. This is my homemade water filter. It is a homemade water filter. It uses Big Berkey filters inside of it. It's kind of a DIY water filter. A lot of people are looking for ways to make their own or build a DIY water filter. This is a DIY water filter. Okay, parts. What do we have? We have a nice little faucet here I found off of Amazon. Along with a nut screws on the back, there's a food grade polyurethane washer between the two to help seal everything off. I went with this because the Big Berkey type filters have the little flippy thing, and I've had issues with those in the past. For those that don't know what a Big Berkey water filter is, they're kind of the Cadillac of water filters. I think they have a couple of shortcomings, but this is a Big Berkey water filter. This is one that I've got. These things retail for right now. I think they're $317. I think it's got some shortcomings. It's a great filter. There's just some things I didn't like about it. One thing I do love about it are the filters. It comes with some awesome candlestick filters. They're a ceramic filter. They run $148 a pair. Okay, so what do we got? We've got two, count them, two food-grade containers, one and two. I found these from a restaurant supply store on the internet, just a random search for a food-grade clear container. I like these because I can see my water levels. With this, you can't. You're just hoping you don't know how much water you got. This thing here, I've got, you know, it's got numbers on it. It's all fancy. I can know where my water levels are at. Innovations. I like this faucet much better. More sturdy, gonna last a lot longer, I think, in my opinion. This little dilly bob right here, as you can see, this is a, I found it online. They call it a metal coffee filter. It actually has little holes through it. You can actually see through it. Little microscopic holes. Okay, the purpose of that thing. Let's say times are hard, it's rough. You want to make your candlestick filters last as long as you can. I think you get 7,000 gallons out of those. Anyway, insert coffee filter into top of lid. Take said coffee filter. Boom. You got a pre-filter. That way you can pour your water in. Pre-filters out anything that might be big enough for that to catch. Hopefully we'll make these filters last longer. Okay, as for how this thing is put together, this is just a plastic lid you can get with the container. Just cut a hole in the top of it. It's big enough to catch the lip of this thing. Fits perfect. Big white piece between the two. You could use a lid like this, but this is, you know, it's a flexible plastic. Got a little wiggle to it. I wanted something a little more solid. I'm bad about over-engineering things. This is actually a food-grade cutting board I picked up at the big super center. For meat cutting and stuff. Cut it out to fit the top of the thing. To get it to stay on, as you can see, I screwed in some pieces. There's one piece there, two pieces over there, one in the back, and one over here. Those keep this from wiggling around or coming out. That way it's solid and it's in there. As for the filters, just drill a couple of holes, stick it through, put the wing nuts on, good to hook. Okay, as for the faucet, it's a 5/8 inch pipe on the back of that. I took a 5/8 inch arbor bit. Drilled a hole through the plastic. Found this nut on Amazon, threads onto the back of it. As for the lid, what I was talking about earlier, you can see right here, I've got one, two, three, four of these little clippy things I put here. Those just fit right down on the inside of this. Keep my lid from wiggling around. It's just a small bolt. There's the head of the bolt right there. It goes through, got a little nut on the backside. And that just keeps everything from wiggling around. That way, when this goes on, it's on. And it's got no wiggle or anything like that to it. So this is good. It does hold more water, quite a bit more water. And I've seen these. Actually, I built one of these. My first one was with 2 5-gallon buckets. And that's really tall. You start stacking up things up. It's a big tipping hazard. Then I use 2 3-gallon buckets. You can get those at your stores that sell cakes and stuff. They use them for icing and things like that in them. So I built one out of 2 3-gallon buckets. It's a little bit nicer, but you couldn't see through it, and I didn't have the actual good faucet. So this is my third rendition, and I think I'm there. I think I'm happy. Anyhow, drop me a comment, hit my like button, tell me what you think. Later.